Are you getting an inaccessible boot device error in Windows? Then you are at the right place, as we know how to fix the issue. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. If you receive an inaccessible boot device error after you have upgraded to Windows 11 or 10, or after you have reset your Windows 11 or 10 PC, then this video shows how to overcome this issue. Let's get started. How to fix inaccessible boot device error in Windows 11 or 10? Here are a few suggestions you can try to resolve the issue. You can edit the boot options or remove any recently added hardware. You can also update to the latest firmware version following this link. If you recently added a driver, restart your computer. Then enter Advanced Boot Options menu and select the last known good configuration option. You may boot Windows into safe mode and try a system restore or a rollback. You can also run checkdisk /F/R on the system partition. If you cannot boot into Windows, use the recovery console and run checkdisk/R or run checkdisk from the repair console. You can also use media creation tool and perform a clean install by clicking on the setup file or booting from the USB. You can follow this guide for details. Advanced troubleshooting for inaccessible boot device error in Windows 11 or 10. Method 1. Check the hard disk connections. Turn off your computer completely and then open the computer case. Now, check all the cables connected to your hard drive. If the cable connections are loose, disconnect the cable and connect them properly. Now turn on the PC and check. Method 2. Verify that the boot disk is accessible. Boot into Advanced Recovery following this link and then open Command Prompt. Microsoft recommends that you execute disk part and then run list disk command to reveal the list of physical drives attached to the computer like this. Here, the UEFI interface will have an asterisk in the GPT column. The BIOS interface will not have an asterisk in the DYN column. If the list disk command lists the OS disks correctly, run the list volume command in disk part. It will show an image like this. This displays volume 1 as the boot disk. If there is no similar listing, you may have to either repair the boot partition following this link or connect with the service center of the OEM. Method 3. Verify the integrity of the boot configuration database. Boot into Advanced Recovery and then open Command Prompt. Type bcdedit and hit Enter. It should show images like this. Here, you can see the identifier is set to default and the device and path point to the correct partition. It can only ensure that the WinLoad file loads correctly. If this is not what you see, you need to fix BCD. The BIOS interface will not have any path but the drive. But the UEFI interface will show a complete path in the device partition parameter. Method 4. Reset BIOS to the default. You can follow this link to reset your computer BIOS to the default. Enter your computer BIOS and find the setting to reset it. You can also remove the CMOS battery and reinsert it. This action will also reset BIOS to the default. Resetting the BIOS to the default will fix the problem if the error occurs due to the incorrect boot order. Method 5. Toggle the VMD controller setting. You can also try to toggle the VMD controller setting in your system BIOS and see if it helps. If the VMD controller setting is enabled, disable it. If the setting is disabled, enable it. If nothing works, perform a clean installation of Windows by following this link. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.